serie a brucia e oggi facciamo caponata di melanzane, peperone e pesce spada.
Rosaria lives in the seaside village of Cornino, close to San Vito Lo Capo in Sicily. Caponata is one of Sicily's famous dishes, and Rosaria's version includes fish. This is Ciccio, Rosaria's local mobile fishmonger. Today, she is buying two slices of swordfish, which are about 300 grams each. The key to good caponata is to cook the ingredients separately. Rosaria likes to boil her celery, not fry it.
Perché è un po' duro. Per la caponata ci vogliono queste melanzane, non quella rotonda viola come ce l'ho qua.
Vedi? Sì,
questa viola serve per friggerla, per fare le cotolette, per fare pesce spada e melanzane. Invece per la caponata questi neri lunghi.
Sicilians prefer the dark purple eggplant or aubergine for caponata. Rosaria cuts two into chunks about 3 centimeters long. The peppers can be red or yellow. Rosaria cuts them the same size as the aubergines and in roughly equal quantities.
Da chi ha imparato a farla? La faceva la sua
mamma. La faceva la mamma, la faceva la nonna. Nonna paterna, perché erano pescatori loro. Invece la mamma sul lato campagna.
While the celery simmers, Rosaria fries the aubergine in corn oil until soft and golden. Olive oil is used later in the tomato dressing. She decants the aubergine into a large saucepan and then fries the pepper pieces in more oil. When they're nice and golden at the edges, they can join the aubergine. When you can prick the celery with a fork, it's done. Rosaria drains the celery and adds this to the pan. These salted capers have been soaking in water. Rosaria adds a generous tablespoon. She slices about 100 grams of green olives and adds these to the vegetables. Next, Rosaria dices 2 onions.
Quando metto la cipolla, gli metto l'olio di oliva.
Perché?
Perché ci devo mettere il concentrato e poi pure un pochino di pomodoro.
She fries these in olive oil until they are soft. Then she empties a tin of tomato concentrate in with the onions. Rosaria fries the mixture until the tomato turns a more muddy red colour. She uses the tomato tin to measure an equal quantity of white wine vinegar. This goes into the frying pan, and she fries it for a minute before decanting the mixture into the saucepan. This is toasted and roughly ground almonds. How much you add is up to you, but Rosaria spoons in 3 tablespoons. She then adds 5 spoons of sugar. This is a matter for your taste buds, finding the right acid-sugar balance. Rosaria also seasons the mixture with 2 teaspoons of salt and plenty of black pepper.
Ora devo fare il pesce spada.
Rosaria has sliced up and rinsed the swordfish.
Lo metto in padella, asciugare un po' d'acqua.
She sautés the pieces in oil and pours in a glass of white wine. Some people think the name caponata comes from the capone fish, which is also known as mahi-mahi or dolphin fish. So you can, of course, omit the fish or use capone instead of swordfish. Rosaria adds around 200 ml of tomato passata to the vegetable mixture. She stirs in the fish along with a little of the frying juices. Rosaria checks the sugar and salt seasoning. Caponata is served at room temperature and is even better the next day. Bread is the best accompaniment. Rosaria's husband is the happy taster.
Posso assaggiarla?
Aspetta.
Buon appetito.
Buono, molto buono.
Si può fare come antipasto, per dire.
Io vado avanti.
Ormai mangia pilla. E stasera non mangi, però.
Click on the subscribe button for regular helpings of Pasta Grannies.